Hi, my name is Danny Watt. So today I wanted to make a video about the fact that tomorrow is my birthday, although by the time you're watching this, it probably is my birthday today, or it's already been, so happy birthday, future me. I'm going to talk about 20 things I've learned in 20 years, although I don't know if I'll be able to think of 20 things, as I don't know if I've learned that many life lessons. I definitely know I could easily, off the top of my head, list 20 stupid things I've done in my life. Does that count? Okay, look, let's just scratch number 20. I'll just list some random things. I mean, it's a lot less pressure that way. We don't have to count it down. So firstly, I hate it when people like announce their birthdays on social media, like Facebook status update. Oh my god, guys, it's my birthday in 2 weeks. Get ready! Don't worry, I do realize that it's entirely hypocritical because I'm literally just making a birthday announcement video right now. This whole video is dedicated to the fact that it's my birthday tomorrow. I just love it when the world revolves around me. But the reason I'm making this video is that I am low-key just freaking out a tiny little bit, or maybe a fucking terrifyingly large amount. Does that even make sense? I don't know. I am scared because I am turning 20 tomorrow. I'm just scared because I'm not going to be a teenager anymore. I know it sounds dumb, but it's just how I've defined myself for the longest time. Like, oh, I'm a teenager, I'm in school. When people ask me what I'm doing, I don't have to have a set plan with my life. I'm just kind of like, yeah, like, I'm just in school, just doing my thing. I feel like a 14-year-old, and I swear on my mum's life, I feel like a 14-year-old, and I felt like a 14-year-old ever since the day I've turned 14, and now I'm almost 20 and I still feel exactly like a 14-year-old. I don't know what taxes are, I don't know how to pay taxes, I don't know how to get my tax return. I'm just gonna get my mum to do that for the rest of my life, because mums know everything, right? I literally cannot even believe I'm 20 tomorrow. Oh my god, that was such a white girl thing to say. Oh my god, I just literally cannot. Like, I literally cannot though. Whenever my family has friends over and we have like dinners together, there's always the adults table and then there's like the teenage kids section that, well, not section, but we just have like our own table. So we'd just have like the kids table, and then the kids would always like go and get the dinner first, and then the adults would go after them. Now, since I'm gonna be 20 tomorrow, I'm not gonna be a teenager anymore. What does this mean for me? Have I upgraded to the adults table since I'm not a fucking teenager anymore? Does this mean that I'm not allowed to go get my dinner first with the rest of the kids? Does this mean I have to wait with the rest of the adults and then sit at the adults table and talk about how great our lives are, doing taxes and going to Briscoe's and getting that great deal on that amazing vacuum cleaner because it's just so damn practical? Actually, just the other day, I voluntarily went into Briscoe's by myself and I actually got really excited about finding a new cool laundry basket, and it was at this exact moment that I realized that I'm not a kid anymore. When I was a kid, I used to think about what I would be like when I was an adult. I used to try really, really hard to picture what I would look like. For some reason, I thought I'd look entirely different. I mean, obviously, people grew up, we look different now. I look different than what I looked like when I was 12. Now that I'm actually grown up, it's just like, is this how I pictured it when I was a child? Like, is this, did I live up to my expectations? I don't know. Ambitions can be good to have, of course, but they can just be such bullshit. And what I mean by this is that ambitions never align with your happiness. You know what I mean? The day you get that great job, or you finally get the promotion you've wanted forever, you think you'll suddenly feel happy and your life will be perfect. But no, it doesn't work like that, sweetie. And I'm still trying to figure this out to this day, because it's an easy thing to say, but it's a hard thing to comprehend. Because you think it will be different, but it won't be. The honest truth that I've learned the hard way is the only time to be happy is now. Right now, at this second that you're watching this video, now is your chance to be happy. Because happiness isn't coming in the future. The only time is now. You're not going to be happy when you get that new job, when you get that new desk, because you know what? There's always going to be another fucking desk that you're going to want. Another thing I've learned as a teenager is to get the fuck out of your fucking boring, fucking shitty, fucking difficult, fucking relationship. You know when people are all like, relationships are hard. Sometimes you're happy for a month, and then sometimes you're really unhappy for 2 months, and then you're happy again for a couple of weeks. Well, let me tell you, that is for when you are like 45 and you're just trying to make your kids happy and you don't want to get a divorce. You should be able to have fun and be in a relationship at the same time. When you're 19, you're supposed to be happy at least like half of the week. If that's not happening, then get the fuck out. There will be someone better that you're more compatible with. Trust me, there will be someone else. I know it doesn't feel like it at the time, but just move on. Another thing I've learned the hard way is don't focus on people that don't focus on you. You know how you just always want someone that you can't have and you just crave their attention because they're not giving it to you? Well, that's not healthy. I know personally that sometimes I can be drawn to people that don't give me enough attention because I'm just like, why don't you like me? How can I change your mind and why do you hate me so much? But you know what? It doesn't mean that they hate you. It just means that you're on different wavelengths. I know that it's really fucking hard to learn because I spent so much of my time wondering why the fuckboy won't text me back. But they don't deserve me. And I don't deserve people that I don't talk to. And that's just how it works, because it takes a whole lot for two different people to be on the exact same wavelength at the same time and both want the exact same things and both be really interested in each other at once. Not only with dating, but with friendships too, and that's just how it works, and life goes on and you will find the right people for you. Now, I don't mean to sound all preachy with some of the stuff that I'm saying, but go and visit your grandparents once in a while. They might be old, they may not know how to use Facebook, and they might think they're sending your message when they're really just commenting on your photo, and they probably don't know what transgender means, but let me tell you, they have some fucking ideas about life, okay? If they've gone 70 plus years without wanting to kill themselves, then they're doing something right. It's fucking dark, but that is fucking true. And they probably have a lot more respectable life advice to give you than what I can give you right now at my mere 20 years of age. On the bright side of not being a teenager anymore, at least I have my nails done. How cute are they? I don't know if that's focused or not, but they look really pretty in person, and when I have my nails done, I feel like I have all of my shit together as an adult, even though I clearly do not. I've also learned to stop caring. Stop caring what people think about you. Stop caring about high school. Stop caring about cliques in high school, because they don't matter, and once you leave high school, it doesn't matter anymore. I remember when I was in high school, I just thought that high school was everything. Just like the high school dramas were just the biggest deals ever, and they were gonna affect me for the rest of my life. I just thought all the people that were popular in high school were just always gonna be like the queens of the world. Whereas that's not true at all, and trust me, high school finishes. And when high school finishes, it's fucking great, you know? Like, people move on, there's no longer this, like, social ladder of popularity. It's just everyone's, or at university anyway, I found that everyone's just really chill and you can be friends with whoever you like, which I absolutely love, and that's how it should be. Another thing I've learned is don't be afraid to say yes. My life has been so much more fun since just saying yes. Just say yes once in a while. Even if you're just like curled up in your bed one weekend and you're so comfortable and you just don't want to go anywhere, if someone invites you out, just say yes. Most of the time you will not regret leaving the house, and some of the best experiences I've had to date have been where I've just said yes. I didn't plan it all out carefully, I didn't really think about what I was doing, but I'd just be like, yes, just say yes. I don't mean it in like that kind of way, like don't say yes if you don't want to, but just say yes to new experiences and meeting new people. Don't be afraid to embarrass yourself. I used to be really conscious of what people thought of me, which it's, yeah, I mean, everyone kind of is to an extent. It's really hard not to do, but I feel like I've gotten so much better at doing it. The other day when I was out shopping, I was wearing a G-string, TMI, but whatever, and I kind of, you know, how you get your girls, you know what I mean, when you kind of get a bit of a wedgie going on there, kind of rides up a little bit. So that was happening, and there was kind of people all around me. There was nowhere that I could do it privately, but I just pulled out that wedgie, and I was proud of it. And I'm pretty sure some people laughed at me, but that's okay, because you know what? I made those people's day. I made them have a good day, you know? They had a laugh, and so I don't care, and neither should you. Even though I'm almost 20, I only learned this like a week ago, and it is that the set on Hannah Montana, like, you know, the beach area with like the little shop that like Rico, is his name Rico had? I don't know, by the beach. The whole beach area is fake. It's not a real beach. It's so fucking obvious now. It's obviously, it never was a real beach. It just looks so fake, even on the show. For some reason, when I was watching it, I just thought that that was a real beach for my whole life, and I've just found out that it's fake, just like the rest of the world. Another thing that I've learned, because some reason I was a fucking retarded child, was I thought that beaches were everywhere. Like whatever town you'd be in or whatever city, I just thought that there was a beach. So when we'd go away somewhere and mum and dad would tell me that there wasn't a beach there, I was just really, really confused. And I had to look at some world maps to realize what the fuck a beach is. So if you're flat smack in the middle of a massive land space of a country, there was not going to be a beach there because there is no water. I'm an idiot. So I feel like that about sums up all my life advice for the age of 20.